It's really different from anything else that you will probably see at BreyerFest.
Free packing peanuts, yay! So it's Thursday morning and we're heading for breakfast. I still should put up maybe some more of my own flyers. Here's one of mine. Beep. Those are cute. So we just had the breakfast at the Clarion, and we're heading back to the room. I have to set up my diorama today, and then I'm gonna sail out of my room later tonight. And then I have to pack up my sail stuff after selling tonight to be sold at the swap meet tomorrow. So kind of have a lot to do today, even though it's not the most busy day. So I don't think I even showed yet the sort of view from the window we have here. Or maybe I did talk about this already. I don't really remember. I don't remember a lot of things anymore. As I've mentioned before, I was up for like 3 days straight almost because I barely got any sleep between those 3 days. But I did get sleep today, so hopefully I'll be a little bit more coherent. Oh, and I'm just so in love with this horse, I can't even... I am so, so happy about him. Oh my god, I love him so, so much. Anyway, what we're going to be doing now is starting to set up my diorama for the diorama contest because we have to enter that tomorrow morning. And I have all the pieces of the diorama, but it is not put together. Even though the stuff is here, it's going to need to be put together and it's going to take a long time to put it all together and require a lot of sticky wax and things. So I'm going to try and do a time-lapse video of me putting it together, and then afterwards I will also show you guys my diorama when it is all put together and such, and give you some details on that. Now my diorama is kind of weird and crazy, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but I thought it was really fun. It's really different from anything else that you will probably hopefully see at BreyerFest, so I'm really excited about that.
So here's the first part of my diorama finished and put together. Pretty much everything with this diorama has been harder than I thought it would be on basically everything here. So here is the little stadium that I have made. I made this out of the poster board foam stuff and then just printed out pictures of textures and things to give it this look. And I also made those little Breyer signs and the little Velociraptor Lava Derby sign. And then I just now finished putting the stablemate hats on the stablemates and sticky waxed them to the platform thing. So hopefully they stay. This is, like I said, a little bit harder than I expected in order to get this to basically all stay together. The mini Whinnies and the sticky wax were not cooperating. And anyway, at least it's done now. So I've just been basically getting my BreyerFest costume and BreyerFest diorama ready. And so my hat and all this stuff was already made at home and stuff, but I've just been getting things out, getting things ready. Like, this is also going with my BreyerFest costume. And then my diorama has been taking the most amount of time. It has taken me very, very long, and it's been kind of frustrating with some things. But it is almost done. We're just concerned still about getting the raptors to stand up. And this one's already, like, leaning, and the horse is falling off, kind of. And so that's the problem I'm having right now, is trying to get this set up. But that is what I've been working on. And I am happy with it so far, pretty much. It's not exactly what I imagined. I did imagine these raptors to be up more, standing up taller, and they would have, like, one leg out to really look like they're running. But because the little stands and stuff aren't really working for them well enough, and I don't have the time or resources to build something, like, specific for them, I'm just kind of having them be the way they are. But I think it still looks pretty cool. Now we'll get some better pictures of it later, because I know this lighting right now is not the best for it, but you get the idea. The only thing I didn't make for this was the horses and the raptors and the horses. Everything else I made, though. So this base I made out of foam board and clay and painted it to look like lava, which I think came out really cool. I'm very, very happy with how that came out. And then the raptors are the beasts of the Mesozoic raptors. They are the red regular raptor and then the blue raptor. And for the stablemates, they're just whatever stablemates I could find that I thought would maybe kind of work. The tack on the raptors, they each have little bridles. You can see they have different bridles. They're actually, each bridle is a little different too. It's not the same exact style. I made them a little different. I made little raptor bridles out of leather and rings and glue. And then I also made little blinkers for them. I decided not to use the blinkers on the blue one because I thought it looked good with just the little fuzzy piece on him. I thought that was cute. So I didn't use blinkers on him, although I did make him a pair of blinkers. I decided not to use them. So the red one has blinkers, and the blue one has blinkers. I think they look really cool. Then for the, also for the raptors, I made them little saddles and little saddle pads. Now this is only a saddle that has stirrups because I ran out of time to make stirrups for the other saddles, but they still look pretty cool. So they have little saddles and saddle pads. Kind of get a look at them there. I don't want to touch this because I don't want it to fall down or anything. We're going to be setting it up and stuff, so I'm not going to pull them off to show you now, but you can get the gist there. And then the stablemates have their little jockey outfits. They each have little helmets, and then they have their own, like, little racing silk designs combined with a blanket. So this one has a pink and blue design. This one has red, yellow, and black. You can see they have little bitty stablemate helmets. I think they're very adorable. This one's probably my favorite jockey outfit I made, is this yellow, purple, and black one, which I think just looks really cool. The blanket came out surprisingly well. I painted each of the blankets as they are there. And then also for the diorama is the fence. I made that too. It didn't come out quite as good as I wanted because I ran out of clay. But it is what it is. So just a little fence there. And then there's also a lot of moss. What I also did with the moss is I burnt some of the moss so that it looks like it's kind of burnt from the lava. So the moss on the edge is like burnt moss stuff. And then the moss in the back is just regular green moss stuff because it hasn't been burnt by the lava eruption that's going on. And so this little stadium thing I made too out of foam board, cardboard stuff, and this is just pictures of textures and things that I printed out and taped to there, which was surprisingly also very difficult and time-consuming to do. And in hindsight, I probably should have, like, actually sculpted some stuff or, like, used different other materials for this. But this was all I could kind of do at the time I had because everything was kind of last minute. But I think it looks cool, and I did a little Breyer like banner on the sides of the stadium there, so I think that looks pretty cool. I did a little Breyer banner on the side, and then I also have a banner in the middle that says the first annual prehistoric Velociraptor Lava Derby. And then I also have that sign technically in a way held up by like little pieces of thread to make it look like it's held up by string or something. And then here is a bunch of spectators in the, like, and this is supposed to be more of a first perspective thing, although it kind of didn't turn out in the way I was imagining, but it still worked out pretty good. So these mini Whinnies are regular horse size, they're just in the distance. So these all little mini Whinnies are watching the race happen, and a lot of them have little hats and things. One of them actually has a tie, that one in the middle there. But they all have little different hats to be like little Kentucky Derby hats and things. So there's all those little guys. And I don't really want to move the diorama around because I'm afraid of bumping what I'm working on with the raptors. But there's a picture of the volcano, of a volcano erupting on the back of the diorama. And that was just kind of to have something on the back there and kind of give a little bit more feel for the environment that I imagine this race taking place. And then I also have my little index card that I made. So that you can see it says the prehistoric Velociraptor Lava Derby. In prehistoric times, horses take racing to a whole new level in which they ride and race dinosaurs. They specifically ride a breed called Velociraptor. I really can't pronounce things, so I'm not going to try that word, but you know what it is. A feathered dinosaur able to run up to 40 miles per hour. The daring Velociraptor Lava Derby takes place near an active volcano, making it all the more thrilling. In this scene, the horses and their raptor steeds are neck and neck as they approach the finish line. In the distance behind them is a crowd of horse spectators, some of which are wearing fancy hats for the special occasion of the first annual Velociraptor Derby. And then for the bottom there, I just put an image of some paleo art by Jose Angel Trenicon Fernandez. So I just wanted a little picture of Velociraptors like that are feathered, so just as a little reference as to what they are. And so that is my diorama. I will take better pictures later and I will post those and show you guys those as well. Dealing with the craziness that is Breyer hotel room shopping plus selling in my own room. So it's double the craziness and excitement. The parking lot's being all filled up. There's so much to look at. It's like, ah. But look at this masterpiece.